This call is now being recorded.
Very good morning, everyone. In the previous class, we discussed briefly about the expressions related to the two important modulation schemes under angle modulation. We know that under angle modulation, we have two important modulation schemes, namely frequency modulation and phase modulation. In the previous class, we have discussed the expressions related to the FM wave and PM wave, and we had also derived the expression for FM PM wave for a sinusoidal message signal. Now today we shall derive the expression for FM wave for a message signal. Okay, given the message signal, we will be deriving the expression for FM wave. And these are the contents in this module. We'll discuss about definitions followed by FM, generation of FM, demodulation, then multiplexing, and PLL followed by super heterodyne receiver. Right. Now, when we talk about the three important analog modulation schemes, we consider amplitude modulation, phase modulation, and frequency modulation. And in the practical scenarios or real world applications, phase modulation or the variants of phase modulation schemes find many more applications as compared to AM and FM. Right. So, and it is particularly useful in digital communication because of its ability to conserve the bandwidth, and that leading to transmission of more data over the bandwidth available. Right. So these are the amplitude modulation scheme waveforms, message signal carrier and AM wave, then FM message signal carrier and modulated wave, followed by PM message signal carrier and modulated wave. Right. And this point is important to note down. Phase modulation uses smaller bandwidth than FM. Thus, we are able to send more information in the given bandwidth using phase modulation as compared to FM modulation, okay, which uses much more bandwidth and transmits low amount of lower information as compared to phase modulation. Okay. And this is the classical example of phase modulation scheme. It is used in dish TV antennas, not exactly phase modulation scheme, a variant of phase modulation scheme. Right. And this is what we have discussed in the previous class. Angle modulation is the broader category of modulation schemes, under which we have phase modulation and frequency modulation. In phase modulation, the phase of the carrier is modulated with respect to the intensity of the message signal. And here we have MFT, which is the message signal, CFT is the carrier signal, and we know that CFT is given by AC cos 2 pi FCT. And here under phase modulation, phi I of t is the modulated phase given by 2 pi FCT plus Kp into M of t, where Kp is the modulation sensitivity, phase modulation sensitivity. So my FM wave, PM wave equation will be equal to S of t is equal to AC cos theta I of t. I'll be substituting for theta, and this is the expression that I'm going to get, right? In the same way, we have frequency modulation, wherein the instantaneous frequency of carrier is modulated with respect to the intensity of the message signal. So here we have Fi of t, which is the instantaneous frequency, which is equal to Fc plus Kf into M of t, where Fc is the carrier frequency, Kf is the modulation sensitivity, M of t is the message signal. And these two components, theta I of t and Fi of t, are closely related. And if I consider the phase of the FM signal, I can write phi I of t is equal to 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KF integral minus 0 to t m tau d tau, right? And using this in the expression, I'll be able to get the expression for FM wave. And as I've already told you, this instantaneous frequency and instantaneous phase are correlated. That is, phi of t is equal to 1 by 2 derivative of theta I of t, and theta I of t is equal to 2 pi integral 0 to t fi tau d tau. So if I know theta I of t, I can get fi of t and vice versa, Okay, so with this, we discussed the sinusoidal message signal, that is m of t is equal to am sine 2 pi fmt. And then using this m of t, we derived the expression for s of t, that is the phase modulated wave expression. And we also extracted the equation for fi of t. And we computed the maximum frequency deviation for phase modulation scheme given the message signal or the message signal expression. And we also computed phase modulation index and maximum phase deviation. Okay, so this was for phase modulation scheme. Now let us consider a frequency modulation scheme, and we will see how to extract the expression for frequency deviation, modulation index, and maximum phase deviation. So before I go there, let me quickly recap what we have discussed. In the phase modulation scheme, theta I of t is varied in accordance with the baseband signal. It is given by 2 pi fct plus kpm of t. First term is the carrier term. Second term has message and phase sensitivity. And this is the expression for PM wave. Likewise, we have FM, wherein instantaneous frequency is varied in accordance with the message signal. And here we can have instantaneous phase given by theta I of t. Okay, and then FM wave expression. And here, as I've already told you, this is the FM wave. The FM wave will have three frequency values. So here at point A, amplitude is zero. So I'll have F naught. Here I'll have F naught plus delta F. And at D, where my amplitude is negative, I'll have F naught minus delta F. And the same is also given here. Right, so carrier swing is the total movement in the signal frequency, that is given by two times your frequency deviation. So it can move to the right side and to the left side. The total movement to the right side and left side is given by carrier swing. And modulation index is the ratio of delta F, that is the frequency deviation, divided by the message signal frequency FM. Okay. Now let us consider the frequency modulation scheme, and then we shall derive the expression for FM wave given the message signal expression. So this is what we had done in the previous class, sinusoidal modulation for phase modulation scheme. We will repeat the same for frequency modulation scheme. In the test or exam, you can expect a question like this. Derive an expression for FM wave, comma, maximum frequency deviation, comma, modulation index, comma, and maximum phase deviation for the message signal given by m of t is equal to am cos 2 pi fm. So you can expect a question like this in the test and in the exam. So we have to derive the expression for FM wave, maximum frequency deviation, modulation index, and maximum phase deviation. And it is one of the important questions. So so here they have given us m of t. We are supposed to first compute fi of t, then theta I of t, and then we can substitute the same in the expression of FM wave. So for that, let us revisit FM scheme equations. So this is the expression for fi of t that we have discussed, that is fc plus kf into m of t So I'll put it here. This is fi of t. Okay. Now here, what should I do? What is the change that I should do? In the place of m of t, what should I write? I'll write am cos am cos 2 pi fm t. Right? In the place of m of t, I've written am cos 2 pi fm t. What is this? This is the instantaneous frequency. This is the instantaneous frequency. Now we have to compute for theta I of t. So yeah, we know that theta I of t is given by the expression 2 pi integral 0 to t fi tau d tau. So we will substitute here. Let me write integral. This is 0 to t. Okay. Now, this expression will be equal to 0 2 pi integral. This is the expression for fi of t that we have. So I'll substitute that. That is fc plus kf am cos 2 pi fm t. Fm tau and d tau. And here I'll have integral 0 to t. Okay. Now, if I perform integration, what will happen to this expression? This will become 2 pi fct plus 2 pi af am into 1 by 2 pi fm. Fm sin 2 pi fm, isn't it? Integral of cos will take sin. So this is the expression that we are going to get after performing integration. Now I can cancel out few terms here. That is 2 pi here in the denominator and 2 pi in the numerator. So I will be left with, I will be left with 2 pi fct plus kf am by fm sin 2 pi fm t. So 2 pi fct plus kf am sin 2 pi fm t. And here in the denominator, I'll be having fm. So this is the expression for I of phi I of t for the given message signal. This is the instantaneous phase. So any doubt so far? Any doubt so far? Any doubt so far? So this is the instantaneous frequency. Now, what is our goal? Our goal is to extract FM wave equation. We know that FM wave equation is given by S of t is equal to AC cos theta I of t. So I'll just copy this expression. Remember, we already have theta I of t here. So what should I do? I should substitute for theta I of t here. So this will be equal to AC cos into, in the place of theta I, I'll write this, that is 2 pi FC t plus AF AM AF AM sine 2 pi FM t. And denominator, in the denominator we will have FM. Okay. Now this is the, what is this? This is the expression for, this is the expression for FM wave for the given message signal. Okay, so we have done with the first part, that is the expression for FM wave. Now we have to derive the expression for maximum frequency deviation. Now for the maximum frequency deviation, what is the expression? This is the expression. So maximum frequency deviation is given by delta F is equal to max mod of mod Fi of t minus Fc. Now Fi of t is here, that is Fc plus Kf Am cos 2 pi FMt minus Fc. So this Fc and this Fc will cancel off. You'll be left with max AF AM cos 2 pi FM t. Now if I take mod, what will happen to this expression? Will have delta F is equal to AF into AM, isn't it? This is the expression for maximum frequency deviation for the given message signal. Okay, so any doubt so far? That's about maximum frequency deviation. Now we know the expression for modulation index, that is beta is equal to delta F by FM. So modulation index is beta is equal to delta F by FM. This in turn is equal to delta F is already known to us, that is kf into am divided by fm. So this is the expression for modulation index. So we have got maximum frequency deviation and modulation index. Now we need to extract maximum frequency deviation, and we know that we need to extract maximum phase deviation, and that is given by theta I of t is equal to max of theta I of t minus 2 pi fc t. So therefore, maximum phase deviation theta I of t is equal to delta theta. It's delta theta is equal to max of theta I of t minus 2 pi fc t. So this is the expression. You can see it is delta theta is equal to max of theta I of t minus 2 pi fc t. Now here, what is theta I of t? This is the expression for theta I of t. So this is the expression for theta I of t we have. Now what should I do? I should substitute theta I of t here in this expression. So when I substitute here, what will happen? I will get this 2 pi fct and this 2 pi fct will cancel off each other, and then when I take mod, what will happen? I'll be left with only kf am by fm. So this is equal to kf am by fm, right? This is the expression for maximum phase deviation. And if you could recall, the modulation index expression that we have got is again kf am by fm. Therefore, delta theta is also equal to what? Beta. That is the modulation index. So beta is equal to kf am by fm, and delta theta is also equal to kf am by fm. Okay, so this is the expression for maximum phase deviation. So we have derived all the expressions for fm wave, maximum frequency deviation, modulation index, and phase deviation, that is the maximum phase deviation. Okay, so any doubt here? Anyone has any doubt in any of the steps? Okay, so moving on. If you have any doubt, you can unmute yourself and ask me, or you can comment in the chat box. So that's about FM for sinusoidal message signal. Okay, expression for FM, delta F, delta theta, and beta for sinusoidal message signal. Okay, so again, I'm just recapping what we have discussed. This is the expression for PM that we have discussed. Omega I of t is the instantaneous angular frequency, and this is the expression for FM wave. Okay, so everything is discussed. This is just a recap. Okay, and this point is important. In FM, angle is directly proportional to the integral of m of t. So if you know the equation for theta I of t, you can extract fi of t. And if I compare fm and pm, fm frequency deviation is proportional to message signal, whereas phase deviation is proportional. This is also frequency deviation is proportional to message signal, but here phase deviation is proportional to the message signal. Noise immunity is superior in PM, right? It is much better than FM. Noise immunity is better than AM. Noise immunity is superior to PM in FM, and in the case of PM, it is better than AM. So if I want to compare the performance of AM, FM and PM with respect to noise immunity, number one will be FM, second is phase modulation, third is AM. Okay, so first is FM, then PM, then AM, and here we will get better signal to noise ratio. But here signal to noise ratio is better than AM, but it is not as good as FM. Okay, and the modulation index is proportional to message signal as well as modulating frequency, but here modulation index is proportional only to the message signal. So you can control the modulation index by using message signal and modulating frequency here, but here modulation index is proportional to the modulating signal m of t, and the expressions for theta I of t and fi of t in the case of FM and PM. Okay, now moving on to a very important topic, that is the properties of angle modulated waves or FM and PM waves, right? So here FM and PM waves are different from AM and AM waves. Thus we need to understand what are the properties of these angle modulated waves. Okay, so this is the carrier signal, this is the message signal, this is AM, this is FM, and this is, sorry, it is, this is PM and this is FM, and this is your C of T, this is your M of T. Okay, so let us see what are the important properties of angle modulated waves, that is FM and AM. We have five important properties, that is consistency, transmitted power is constant, non-linearity in the modulation process, irregularity of zero crossing, visualization, difficulty of the message signal, and a trade-off between transmission bandwidth and noise performance. So first, constancy of transmitted power. We know that the four phase modulation scheme theta I of t is given by 2 pi fct plus kp m of t, and fm theta I of t is 2 pi fct plus 2 pi kf integral 0 to t m tau d tau. Now if you observe both the expression, you will find that the amplitude is fixed, that is it is fixed at ac, where AC is the amplitude of your carrier signal. That means the amplitude of your FM or PM will be constant to the value of your carrier amplitude for all the values of T. Therefore, if I want to compute the average transmitted power, I can compute it as P average is equal to 1 by 2 AC square. You know that P is equal to V square by R. If I consider average, it will be this expression V square by R. Here we are assuming R is equal to 1, load resistance is equal to 1. Therefore, what will happen to this expression? And V is equal to AC. So, what will happen to this expression? V average will be equal to 1 by 2 AC square. Okay, so that's what we have got. So in the case of FM and PM, the average transmitted power is 1 by 2 AC square. So by controlling the amplitude of your carrier signal, you can control the average transmitted power, right? Next property is non-linearity of the modulation process. As you have already seen, waves, this angle, these are angle modulation schemes, FM and PM, don't have linear behavior. They are non-linear, and we can verify that by using the principle of superposition. Okay, so please pay attention and listen carefully. Suppose you have a message signal which is given by m of t is equal to m1 of t plus m2 of t, and if I ask you to compute s of t, s1 of t and s2 of t, which is nothing but the PM wave produced by considering m of t, m1 of t and m2 of t, you will write the expressions as s of t is equal to ac cos 2 pi fct plus kp into m1 of t plus m2 of t. And if I ask you to write s1 of t, you will write ac cos 2 pi fct plus kp m1 of t. And for s2, you will write ac cos 2 pi fct plus kp m2 of t. Now, if you look at the expression for superposition principle or theorem 2, obey or satisfied, this s of t should be equal to s1 of t plus s2 of t, isn't it? By looking at the expression, by looking at this expression, tell me whether this is correct or not. Is s of t equal to s1 of t plus s2 of t, or whether it is not equal? Answer me in the chat box. Is it equal to s1 of t plus s2 of t, or it is not equal? Yes, answer me in the chat box. There are only two options, either equal or not equal. Yes, very good. Mukta has given me the answer. It is the right answer. It is not equal, right? Because this is kp m1 of t, this is kp into m1 of t plus m2 of t. So obviously this s of t is not equal to s1 of t plus s2 of t. Thus, this expression does not obey the superposition principle. If it does not obey superposition principle, then we can consider the modulation process to be non-linear in nature. Okay. That's about property 2. Moving on to third property, irregularity of the zero crossings. These are the expressions for the phase of PM and FM signals. And here you can see zero crossing is nothing but the time instance at which waveform changes its amplitude from negative to positive or positive to negative. And here you can clearly see that in the case of PM and FM, there is no regularity in the zero crossing between positive and negative amplitude. So it is non-linear. There is a lot of irregularity between the zero crossing of waves from positive to negative cycle. You can see here it is taking more time to cross from positive to negative. Here it is taking less time. So there is irregularity. This irregularity is attributed to the non-linear character of the modulation scheme or the process involved in PM and FM. Okay, and this is one of the important properties of angle modulation scheme, that is irregularity of zero crossings. Then fourth property is visualization difficulty of the message waveform. Now this is very straightforward. If you pay attention to the AM wave, you can see on top of the AM wave, your message envelope is present. You can see here, I can draw a waveform like this, and I can visualize this, and I can see what is the shape of the message signal. In the case of AM. But in the case of PM and FM, we cannot visualize the message signal. Okay, so difficulty in visualizing the message signal in the case of PM and FM. If you look at AM wave, you can easily visualize M of T, which will be the envelope of AM. But in the case of PM and FM, it is difficult to visualize the presence of message signal. Okay, but in AM you can easily visualize the presence of the message signal. That is the fourth property. Okay, and again this is attributed to the nonlinear character of the modulation process. The last property is trade-off between the increased transmission bandwidth and improved noise immunity. So I have been telling you that in the FM and PM modulation schemes, we have a better noise immunity. The better noise immunity that we are getting in the case of FM and PM is attributed to increase in the transmission bandwidth. Because of the increase in the transmission bandwidth, we are getting improvement in the noise performance. But to get this improvement, we are paying a lot of money for usage of bandwidth. Thus, improvement of noise immunity is obtained by at the expense of increased transmission bandwidth. Okay, and thus it is a trade-off in FM and PM. But in the case of AM, we do not have this trade-off because transmission bandwidth in AM is fixed, right? If you are using the conventional amplitude modulation scheme, it will be 2W. If you are using double sideband, again, it will be 2W. If you are using single sideband, it will be W. But transmission bandwidth is fixed. Thus, the noise immunity is relatively lower in the case of AM or AM variants as compared to PM and FM. Just to give you a glimpse of this comparison, you have AM. After this, you have we have studied DSP, SC. Then we have studied SSB, isn't it? These two are the variants of AM, right? And here we had used bandwidth of 2W. Here also it was 2W, but here it was W, right? But in the case of FM and PM, we can use large bandwidth. When I have large transmission bandwidth, what will happen to my noise immunity? My noise immunity or the presence of noise will decrease. But here, the presence of noise is relatively higher as compared to FM and PM, right? But if I want to achieve better noise immunity, what am I paying for? I'm paying for larger bandwidth, and larger bandwidth is an expensive commodity to have, because if you want to have larger bandwidth, you have to pay more money. Thus, for better performance, you are paying more money, right? That is the fifth property of angle modulation scheme. Okay, when I say angle modulation scheme, I'm referring to both FM as well as PM. Okay, so that's about the five important properties. In the next class, we shall discuss about zero crossings in the case of FM and PM. Okay, so any doubts so far in the concepts that I've discussed? Any doubts so far in the concepts that I've discussed today?
Sir, anyone? You explained zero crossing with respect to some wave, right?
Yes. Yeah, I'll just. Yes. I'll just repeat it. Yes. See here, important information related to the message signal can be obtained by zero crossing in general. If you look at AM, pay attention and listen to this part first. If you look at AM, the movement of the signal moving from positive to negative is same for this wave as well as this wave. For example, if this is taking time t1 for the movement from positive amplitude to negative amplitude, this is also going to take a time of same t1, isn't it? Similarly, this will also take same time for the movement of signal from positive amplitude to negative amplitude, or vice versa. And this is linear. Agreed? Is this clear? Is this part clear? This signal, which is in positive amplitude, will come to negative amplitude, and the time taken for the signal to move from positive to negative for this wave and this wave and this wave are all same. They are linear, right? But here in the case of PM, if you pay attention here, look at this part. If I just consider this wave if I consider this wave, it is moving from positive to negative at a much faster rate as compared to this wave, isn't it? Yes or no? This is taking much lesser time, say 1 nanosecond, and this is taking say 4 nanosecond, right? So there is no regularity, isn't it? There is no regularity in the case of PM wave, right? Again, in the case of FM, you can see here, if I consider this part of the wave, the signal is moving from positive amplitude to negative amplitude, say for a in a time duration of 1 nanosecond. But if I consider this wave, this is taking 4 nanoseconds to move from positive amplitude to negative amplitude. So do you call this as regularity? Obviously no, right? Thus, in the case of PM and FM, we do not have regularity in the zero crossings as we have in the case of AM. Is this clear?
Got it. Thank you.
Okay. So that's about the properties related to angle modulation scheme. Okay. So if you have any doubts, you can unmute yourself and ask me or comment in the chat box, or else I'll take the attendance. Just a second, I'll take the attendance. Yes, Lavanya M has asked me which modulation scheme uses lesser bandwidth to transmit more information. I've been telling you